before the money will come, it must have broken you. I'm serious. It will break you, pieces you, mold you back again before the money will finally then.
Hi guys, you're all welcome to my channel today. If this is your first time ever tuning in, hello. I'm so glad to have you. My name is Chizoba and I'm a medical doctor living in Kiev, Ukraine. It's actually weird saying I'm a medical doctor. I'm getting used to that. Anyways, if you already subscribed to my channel, you already watched my videos, thank you so much for all the love and the support you show me. You're the real ones and I do not take you guys for granted. So you guys, before we get ahead with today's video, which you already can see by the title, a quick update. I already have my braces. I fixed the upper layer of my braces 2 weeks ago, was it? Yeah, 2 weeks ago. And the lower one is gonna be done in 2 weeks' time. And if you guys are interested to see more or learn more about braces, or if you're just interested in anything about braces, do let me know in the comment section below and I'll be glad to make a video around that. And yeah, you can see I got the ceramic ones. It's a kind of blend with my teeth, so you can hardly accept it come really into my face. Then you can see that I'm wearing braces, but other than that, it blends very well with my feet. So you guys, in today's video, you can already see the title, so let us jump right into it. I'm gonna be talking about the main reason why you should not start a YouTube channel. If money is the reason or the inspiration behind you wanting to start a YouTube channel, I want to say right now, no, do not do it. In fact, let's even leave the inspiration. Money can inspire you to make money off of YouTube, can be the inspiration, but if that is the main reason why you're starting the channel, sis, you're gonna be very frustrated. You're gonna run out of patience for it, because it will eventually never come. Let me put it this way, okay? YouTube is like every other career. That's the way I've come to see it right now. YouTube is like every other career, every other lucrative career that people look at. For example, in Africa, and especially in Nigeria, they know that if you study medicine, if you're a medical doctor, they see you as one billionaire, you know, living up high there, you have money, But then a lot of people go into medicine with the fact that, you know, I want to make a lot of money, and that's why they go to study medicine. And they cannot even go through the process of becoming a medical doctor because they get very, very frustrated along the line. That is the same thing that happens when you're studying YouTube for money. If you're studying medicine for other reasons, for example, you love medicine, you love to save lives, other reasons apart from making money, it means that you can endure the fact that you're not making money yet until you start making money. For example, I'm gonna keep using medicine, because for you to become a medical doctor, you have to go through 6 years of medical school, and you also have to go through 1 year of, for example, in Nigeria, you have to go through 6 years of medical school, which sometimes turns to be 8-9 years because of, we know why, but whatever. Normal standard, 6 years of medical school, 1 year of house job, 1 year of youth service, because before you can, you know, start earning some good money. So altogether, on a normal, you know, basic circumstances, you should go through medical school in like 8 years, right? And you're becoming a doctor, So if you are doing medicine for other reasons, you cannot have the patience to wait for 8 good years before you can start earning money. Right? If money is the only thing, it means you have to endure a lot of other things through the 8 years. So what is keeping you through that 8 years to the point where you're not making money? That is the other reason. That is how it is in the YouTube space. If your inspiration is money, what are you gonna do for the, you know, first 8 years or whatever, how many period of time that you're not yet making money? What are you gonna do before you start making money? What is going to sustain you? What is going to keep you inspired? What is going to keep you motivated to keep making videos before you start, you know, making money? If there is no other reason, there is nothing else that is inspiring you and it's just money, you have just put yourself in a very, very bad career choice, and you very put yourself in a very wrong path. It's going to end in frustration. It's going to end in You've wasted a lot of time, you've wasted a lot of money, you've wasted a lot of things, and still you're not making money. I'll use myself as an example. I started YouTube 2 years ago, two months ago in August, I do 2 years anniversary of my channel. But you guys will not believe I have not even made a dime out of YouTube. And let's even say, let's put into consideration how much I've invested into YouTube. I've invested my own money, I've invested my own time, I've invested everything, my headspace, my ideas, I've invested myself into YouTube, right? But I've still not made anything out of it. In monetary terms, I've not made any money. So if money was the reason why I started YouTube, and for 2 years now I haven't made any money, all I've done is to give, and I haven't gotten anything back in return, imagine how frustrated I would be if money is my main reason of wanting to start this channel. So it brings me to say this. I was listening to a quote. I'm gonna read it out from my phone, by the way. It says, people value you at the rate which you can add value to them. Okay, I listened to a lot of things and I've forgotten who I heard this from. People value you at the rate at which you can add value to them. So let's put it this way. People are watching your video. The only reason why you're going to make money on YouTube is the fact that a lot of people are watching your videos. A lot of people are engaged in your channel. A lot of people want to invest in you time-wise. Just time-wise and everything, data-wise, especially in Nigeria where data is a lot of money, they want to invest their money, they want to invest their time, and they want to invest a lot of themselves to you. So the only reason why people can do that is if you are adding value to them. So if the reason why you started the channel is to take money from them, you know, make money from them, or make money by them watching your video from them, literally, it means that nobody's gonna value that. If no one can see the value that you're adding to their lives, they are not interested in investing their own, you know, time in you. Okay, let me put it this way. I can only go ahead and invest my time, invest my money, my data money, on watching Dimaume, which was one of my favorite YouTubers in Nigeria, one of my favorite YouTubers worldwide. I can only invest my time in her. I can only, you know, value her because of the value she's adding to my life. Do you understand? So it brings me to say, first, you want to add value to people before they would want to, you know, come back together or come back again to appreciate the value or appreciate you. People appreciate you, people value you because of the value you're adding to their lives. So keep that in mind. And the second thing is, to impact people, you need to build relationship, be generous, give without expecting nothing in return. Okay? If you want to impact people, you want people to learn, you want people to come back to you, you have to learn how to give without expecting anything in return. You have to learn how to make videos, or you want to learn how to do things that will only give you nothing in return. You're only getting maybe nothing from them, but you're getting satisfaction from your own inner peace of mind, right? Let's say you started YouTube for the fact that, okay, you want to teach people, and you're making the videos and one person is very appreciative of what you've taught, what you've done, da 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 da. All that will come back to you getting satisfaction within your mind, right? But if you're expecting people to watch your videos, do the comment, da 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 da, share it, do that, do this, without you having done anything for them, you're basically actually getting nothing. Okay, so the right thing to do is try your best to impact other people. Try your best to want to give other people without expecting them to give you anything back in return. I've learned that the most successful people in life, I've looked around, I've done some research, the most successful people in life are the people that want to give without expecting things in return. They end up getting all they want without actually expecting it. And sometimes, and I'm sure you watching this, you agree with me that there are some times that you've done some things without expecting, you know, anything in return. And those were the times that you got blessed, like, even more. But there were times that you just did things out of, you didn't even expect that, you know, that person will appreciate it that way, or you didn't expect that, 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 and you just did it. And that's when you're getting a lot in return. Even the Bible say, give, because givers never lack. So if you're given your knowledge, if you're given your skills, your whatever, genuinely, without actually expecting things in return from people, that's when you're actually going to get more. The only way you're going to impact someone's life is the fact that you've sat down and say, I want to teach you, I want to make you learn this, I want to make you learn that, without actually expecting that, I want you to pay me money in return, I want you to be very appreciative, I want you to send the video to all your friends to watch, da 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 da. So you see, learn to, you know, give, learn to impact other people, learn to share yourself with the world without expecting them to bow down at your feet and worship you. You're not God. Nobody wants to worship you. The last thing that I want to say is, you will never realize your potential to impact other people until you break from selfishness. Yeah, so this brings me to, like, the last point that I want to make in this video. You will never know how much you're going to impact other people, right? You never realize that you have the potentials of impacting other people if you keep being selfish. Selfish in the sense that I'm only giving you this because I know you're going to give me that in return. I'm only showing love to you. I'm only showing that and that and that and that. I'm only making this video because I know that's what will go viral. I'm only making this because I want to make money out of it. The moment you start, you know, attaching selfish desires or attaching needs and wants and, you know, gift, attaching some kind of price tag to the services you render to people, that's when you get nothing. This guy that wrote The Gym, I cannot pronounce his name. I'll put his name here. The guy that wrote Rich Dad Poor Dad book, he said something. He said, the moment you start collecting a pay slip, that's the moment you stop thinking. Your mentality to grow forward just ends. So it's also the same thing. The moment you start expecting that people will always worship you, people will always give you gifts, people, you always get PR packages, da 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 da, you always get money from people. The moment you start attaching a price tag to the services that you render, that's the moment that the value of the services you're rendering becomes useless. Okay, so try your best, okay, to let other things be the reason why you want to start a YouTube channel. There are so many other things that can inspire you to start a channel apart from money. Money, I call money the fruit or the icing to the cake that you're making. That's what I call making money off of YouTube. If that's the main reason, there's no, your cake is just gonna be icing, it's just gonna be just sugar, right? So the moment you keep feeding people sugar, 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 they're gonna get to decay from that, and they don't want sugar. Nobody wants to keep eating sugar because sugar is bad for their body. So the moment everything you do on YouTube, or everything you want to do on YouTube, is centered around the fact that you want to make money off of it, a lot of people are going to get tired of consuming the sugar that you're giving to them. And then the next thing, they are going to start drawing backward, and you know what? I don't want to do this. I don't want to keep eating sugar. I want some real cake. I want some flour mixed with something else, not just sugar. So let money be the secondary factor. Let it inspire you to want to start, but find another reason, another thing that will be your driving force to. I've noticed that a lot of people that started YouTube because they want to make money, they bring about what we call reputation in this YouTube space. That's why you can see a cut crease eyeshadow tutorial 20 times and nothing has been done differently from it. So if that brings the, you know, the same thing that I'm saying, if you keep feeding people sugar, 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 they're gonna get tired of the sugar and they don't want to take it. So if people see that all you do is copy and paste other people's idea, because this idea gave Mr. A $20 million, whatever, not possible. And you want to copy the same exact idea that Mr. A has done, and you think you're going to make $20 million from it. No, you're not going to make any money from it, because anything that do not come from your heart, anything that you have not thought of, if you do not put time, effort, and a lot of thinking into a thing, it will show that you didn't do any research about it. It will show that nothing. You're just an empty drone that is copying another person's idea and putting it into place. Other people's idea can inspire you, you know, but do not let the end game of what they do be what is inspiring you. For example, I would take Dima Ome, she's my favorite YouTuber, I'll keep talking about her. I'll take the fact that she was making a video where she talked about money that she made, how much money she'd be making on YouTube, and if that's the video that want to inspire me, and the fact that Dima Ome is making, for example, $1,000 to $3,000 on a monthly basis, and that I'm like, wow, that's what I want to do. And you know, I just take that point and I start doing everything that Dima is doing. I'm not gonna get the results that she's getting, because behind the fact that she's, before she got to the level of making $3,000 on a monthly basis, there were other works that she put into place. Before her cake was ready for icing, she's made the cake, she put it in the oven, she's done this, done that, she's done gone through the whole process of making the cake and then icing it to present it to us, and we're like, wow, you see, wow, she's making $3,000, oh my god, da, 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 da. And that's the only part that you see and you want it to inspire you. If that's the kind of inspiration that you want to get, you will never move forward in this space. That's one thing I found, that you will never move forward. You will be so frustrated. Like, I'm telling you, there is so much, I cannot, you know, overemphasize the fact that there is so much work that goes behind closed doors of making YouTube videos. We all know that. The filming, the editing, the time wasting for you to be able to come up with ideas. For example, this particular video, this is the take three. This is the third time I'm filming this video, and each time I filmed it, I'm like, ah, something is wrong. Ah, something is wrong. Oh, something is wrong. I don't like this. I don't like that. You see, if you cannot be able to be patient, if there is nothing else that is your driving factor that is making you do it, if it's just for the money, take for example, like I've told you guys, me, you will be so frustrated, because before the money will come, it must have broken you. I'm serious. It will break you, pieces you, mold you back again before the money will finally then come. I have stories of a lot of YouTubers. I was watching a YouTube video yesterday, and the girl was like, she's been on the YouTube, she has 8.4 million followers, and she's like, she's been in the YouTube space for 4 years before she was able to get her first paycheck. And I'm like, really? So you see, don't let that money be the driving factor. Let other things be the reason. Money can inspire you, but let other things be the reason and the driving factor why you are making, or why you want to start a YouTube channel. I hope that you guys have learned something from this. And for the people that will say, other, I am not saying that money should not inspire you. Let me say it out in plain terms. Money should inspire you, but do not let it be the reason why you start the channel, okay? Let other things be the reason why, let the money be the product of all the hard work that you've put in. Huh? It's the end road that you want to get to. But before you get to this place, from here, you have to go through a lot of hurdles in order to get here. So be patient enough. Let other things be inspiring you while you're going through the hurdles, and while you're thinking all the difficulties and the challenges, while you're breaking them one step at a time in order to get here. Let something else be what is driving you and pushing you and making you want to go forward, want to move forward, want to get here. Let it not be money. If it's money, you're going to break down like almost at the first level, and you don't want to do that. So I hope this video have inspired someone. I hope this video have helped someone and have answered a lot of questions for a lot of people. And if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. Or if you don't like it, give it a thumbs down as well. I would not mind. And if you have any other thing to say or any questions or anything at all, do leave it in the comment section below. I will be glad to see what you guys think about this topic. Let me know in the comment section. Let's start up a conversation. Let's start up a conversation there about this. Do you think right or wrong or whatever? What do you think about money being the reason why people are starting a YouTube channel? Let me know in the comment section below. And yes, if you guys would like me to do a video of things that you want to inspire you, like reasons why you should start up a YouTube channel, I will be really, really so glad to do that. Also, let me know in the comment section below. I love you guys. I appreciate you. Thank you for the support. Do not forget to click the subscribe button if you are not yet subscribed. Until next time, watch my other videos. I'm going to leave a link so that you guys can see them. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.